So next two questions from Motion. A ball is dropped from a height of 100 meter. 100 meter की height से एक ball को free fall कराया गया, drop किया गया, gravity के अंदर उसको release कर दिया. Find the time required to fall and the final velocity. हमको क्या निकालनी है कि उसको ground level 100 meter की height से ground level तक जाने में कितना time लगेगा और कितनी वेलोसिटी होगी जब वो ग्राउंड्स को जस्ट टच करने वाला होगा. ओके, सो लेट्स राइट द गिवन पार्ट. सो द हाइट इज हाउ मच? हाइट इज 100 मीटर. वी नीड टू फाइंड एंड वी आर प्रोवाइडेड विद द एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी. हाउ मच इज द एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी? इट इज 10 meter per second square. The body is dropped. So the initial velocity will be what? Will be 0 meter per second. It is dropped. It is not thrown. Okay. So the initial velocity will be 0 meter per second. Okay. And what is the height? Height is 100 meter. So this is just become your displacement. What is the gravity? The body is falling down and even the gravity is in same direction. So I'll write as plus 10 meter per second, because the motion and acceleration both are in the same direction, so we will take the acceleration as positive. Okay, so now we can do it. We need to find the final velocity and even we need to find the time. So for final velocity we can use the formula v square minus u square is equal to 2 gh. Okay, so v square minus what is u? U is 0. So 0 square is equal to 2gh. 2 into g is 10 into h is how much? 100. So therefore v will become root over, this becomes 2000. So that is, what is 2000? It is 400 into 5. Okay. And what is the root of 400? Yes, it is 20. So, the final result is 20 root 5. So, the final velocity is 20 root 5 meter per second. What is the time? We also need to find the time. So, for time, what you can do is, you can use the formula v is equal to u plus at. V is equal to u plus at. What is v? V is equal to, we already obtained it, it is 20 root 5. What is u? U is 0. A is 10. Yes, it is 10 into t. So what is t? T is 20 root 5 upon 10. 10 into 2 is 20. So the time is 2 root 5. Second, time is 2 root 5 second, right? In the next set, we have a stone which is thrown vertically upwards. It is thrown up, okay, with a velocity of. So, what is the velocity with which it is thrown? That velocity is 19.6 meter per second, okay? And if it is thrown vertically upwards, the velocity will go on decreasing as it is going up. Okay, so at the highest point, what will be the velocity? It will become 0 meter per second, right? Because acceleration due to gravity is pulling it down, and because the motion is up and gravity is acting down, I will take, in this case, because opposite direction, I'll take gravity as negative and it is given 9.8, so minus 9.8 meter per second square, right? Also, so these are the given part. What we need to find is, we need to find the height which it will reach, okay, and also we need to find the total time. So let's solve for the height. So the height is, we are provided with u, v and acceleration. So we'll use the formula. Yes, 2as is equal to v square minus u square. What is acceleration? It is minus 9.8 into height. We need to find, so s is equal to height. Okay, here the displacement is the height attained. So we need to find that height. So I wrote h instead of s. Okay, and v square, that is 0 square minus u. How much it is? 19.6 the whole square, right? So it will become minus 19.6. This is 2 into minus 9.8, which is 9, minus 19.6. H is equal to minus 19.6 into 19.6 because it is square, right? Okay, so the minus sign gets cancelled and 119.6 gets cancelled. So it will be 19.6 meter, the height attained will be 19.6 meter, and we also need to find the time. So if it is going up in any, during any such case, if a body is going up with and it is taking time t, then the same time is required to come down. So if I need to find the total time, the time of ascent as well as the time of descent, the time of going up as well as the time of going down, so what I just need to find is the one part, and I'll multiply it with 2. Okay, so here I'll just find the time which it will require to go to the highest point, right? So in this case, if I need to find the time, I'll use the basic formula. Yes, what is that? It is, yes, acceleration, the formula of acceleration. What is acceleration? Acceleration is final minus initial velocity by time. So what is the acceleration? Minus 9.8. what is the final velocity? 0. And what is the initial velocity? 19.6 by time. So what is time here? I'll take the time here. So t is equal to minus 19.6 by minus 9.8. So it is 9.8 into 2 is 19.6. So time is equal to 2 seconds. 2 seconds go to the highest point. But we need to find the total time to go up as well as to go down. So that will be 2 seconds to go up and 2 seconds to go down. So how much is the total time? Yes, it is 4 seconds.